Monty Python's Flying Circus.
Good evening.
Hello again, and welcome to the show. Tonight, we continue to look at some famous deaths. Tonight, we start with the wonderful death of Genghis Khan, conqueror of India. Take it away, Genghis.
Nine point one, 9.3, 9.7. That's 28.1 for Genghis Khan.
Bad luck, Genghis. Nice to have you on the show. And for now, here are the scores.
Well, there you can see the scores now. St. Stephen in the lead there with his stoning. Then comes King Richard III at Bosworth Field, the grand death that. Then the very lovely John Dark. Then Marat in his bath. Best of friends with Charlotte in the showers afterwards. Then Abe Lincoln of the US of A, a grand little chap that, and at number six, Genghis Khan, and the back marker, King Edward VII. Back to you, Wolfgang.
Thank you, Eddie. And now time for this week's request death. For Mr. and Mrs. Violet Stebbings of 23 Wolverstone Road, Hull, the death of Mr. Bruce Foster of Guildford.
Struth!
Oh, blimey, how time flies. Sadly, we are reaching the end of yet another program, and so it is finale time. We are proud to be bringing to you one of the evergreen bucket kickers. Yes, the wonderful death of the famous English Admiral Nelson.
Kiss me, honey!
Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to the second of our Italian language classes, in which we'll be helping you brush up your Italian. Now, last week we started at the beginning and we learned the Italian for a spoon. Now, I wonder how many of you can remember what it was.
Sit down, Mario.
Giuseppe.
Il cucchiaio.
Ah, well done, Giuseppe. Or, as the Italians would say, molto bene, Giuseppe.
Grazie, signore. Grazie di tutta la sua gentilezza.
Yes. Well, now, this week, we're going to learn some useful phrases to help us open a conversation with an Italian. Now, first of all, try telling him where you come from. For example, I would say, sono inglese de Gerard's Cross. I am an Englishman from Gerard's Cross. Shall we all try that together?
Yeah. Si, si.
Sono inglese, they tell us the cost.
Not too bad. Now let's try with somebody else. Mr...
Mariolini,
signore. Ah, Mr. Mariolini. And where are you from?
Napoli, signore.
Oh, you're Italian?
Si, si, si.
Well, in that case, you would say, sono italiano de Napoli.
Ah, capisco. Mille grazie, signore.
Per favore, yes? Signore. Non conosco Napoli, ma signore, devo mi polo sono italiano de Napoli quando vi abitare de Milano.
Ok, stupito.
Sorry, I don't understand.
Signor, my friend is saying...
Bitte, mein Herr! Bitte,
yes,
bitte!
Yes.
Was ist das Wort für Mittelschmutz?
Oh, Helmut, you want the German classes.
Oh, danke schön. Ah, das deutsche Klassenzimmer.
My friend is saying... He say, one must say, I am Italian from Napoli when he lives in Milan.
Ah, well, tell your friend, if he lives in Milan, he must say, sono italiano de Milano.
Milano è tanto meglio di Napoli.
Che cosa?
Sì, Milano è tanto meglio, c'è del mondo.
He say Milan is better than Napoli.
Napoli. Sì. Oh, well, he shouldn't be saying that. We haven't done comparatives yet.
No, che questo.
Yes, Mother's new improved Whizzle butter containing 10% more or less is absolutely indistinguishable from a dead crab. Remember, buy Whizzle butter and go to heaven.
I can't tell the difference between Whizzle butter and this dead crab.
Yes, you know, we find that 9 out of 10 British housewives can't tell the difference between Whizzle butter and a dead crab.
You're on television, aren't you?
Yes, yes.
Oh, yes! Yes, 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 yes. That's that thing with those silly women. You can't tell the difference between Whizzle butter and a dead crab.
Oh, yes, yes, yes! You try that around here, young man, and we'll slit your face.
Yes! Yes! Yes.
Oh, he's not open.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to another edition of It's the Arts. We kick off tonight with the cinema.
Good evening. One of the most prolific of film producers of this age, or indeed any age, is Sir Edward Ross, back in this country for the first time for 5 years to open a season of his works at the National Film Theatre, and we are very fortunate to have him with us here in the studio this evening.
Good evening.
Edward, you don't mind if I call you Edward?
No, not at all, fine.
Only it does worry some people. I don't know why, perhaps a little sensitive, so I do take the precaution of asking on these occasions.
No, that's fine.
Forgot. So Ed was all right. Splendid.
Splendid.
Sorry to have brought it up, Ernie.
No, Edward it is.
Well, thank you very much indeed for being so helpful. Ernie, it's more than my job's worth to go on.
Quite, yes.
Makes it rather difficult to establish a rapport to put the other person at their ease.
Quite.
Yes, silly little point, but it does seem to matter. Still, less said the better. Ted, when you first started in the... You don't mind if I call you Ted?
No. Everyone calls me Ted.
Sure. Well, it's shorter, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yes, and much less formal.
Yeah. Yep. Yes. Ted, Edward, anything.
Splendid. Incidentally, do call me Tom. I don't want you playing around with any of this Thomas nonsense. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. Eddie, baby, when you first
I'm sorry. I don't like being called Eddie, baby.
I'm sorry?
I don't like being called Eddie, baby.
Did I call you Eddie, baby?
Yes, you did. Now get on with it.
Don't think I did call you Eddie, baby.
I didn't call you Eddie, baby.
Did I call him Eddie, baby?
No. Yes! No!
I didn't really call you Eddie, baby, did I, sweetie?
Don't call me a sweetie!
Can I call you Sugar Plum?
No!
Pussycat?
No!
Angel Drawers?
No, you may not! Now get on with it, Frank!
What? Can I call you Frank? Why Frank? It's a nice name. Robin Day's got a hedgehog called Frank.
Now,
Frank.
What's going on?
Franny, little Franny. Franny Nickers.
No,
face.
I'm leaving.
Franny Nickers.
I'm leaving. What? I'm off.
Tell us about your latest films, Redwood.
What?
Tell us about your latest film, if you'll be so kind, Sir Edward.
None of this. pussycat nonsense.
Promise. Please, Redwood.
My latest film?
Yes, sir.
Well, the idea, funnily enough, came from an idea I had when I first joined the industry in 1919. Of course, in those days, I was only a tea boy.
Oh, shut up.